Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and we're going to cover three updates, starting with US plans to keep Russia under pressure in space while they threaten the US regarding the International Space Station. US President Joe Biden said, "We estimate that we will cut off more than half of Russia's high-tech imports, and it will strike a blow to their ability to continue to modernize their military. It will degrade their aerospace industry, including their space program." He said that Russia's space program won't be spared from U.S. sanctions in the present situation of Russia's invasion in Ukraine. On the 24th of February, a fact sheet from the White House was published, but as per reports, it did not clarify the exact sanctions or restrictions the U.S. put on Russia's space program. The fact sheet specified that it's imposing Russia-wide denial of exports of sensitive technology, primarily targeting the Russian defense, aviation, and maritime sectors to cut off Russia's access to cutting-edge technology. These severe and sustained controls will cut off Russia's access to cutting-edge technology. On the 24th of February, NASA said, "The new export control measures will continue to allow U.S.-Russia civil space cooperation. No changes are planned to the agency's support for ongoing in-orbit and ground station operations." While talking about the influence of the present war situation on space cooperation with Russia, UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson said, "We will have to see what further downstream effects there are on collaboration of all kinds. I must say that hitherto, I've been broadly in favor of continuing artistic and scientific collaboration. But in the current circumstances, it's hard to see how even those can continue as normal." Dmitry Rogozin, Director General of Roscosmos and former Deputy Prime Minister of Russia, said, "Do you want to block our access to radiation-resistant space microelectronics?" He pointed out that Russia will continue to make their own spacecraft. "And we will do them by expanding the production of the necessary components and devices at home, while strictly criticizing the sanctions on Russian launch vehicles for destroying the space competition." Rogozin said, "We're ready to act here too." Rogozin also raised questions about the future of the International Space Station, ISS. He asked, "Do you want to destroy our cooperation on the ISS? If you block cooperation with us, who will save the ISS from an uncontrolled deorbit and fall into the United States or Europe?" Rogozin also attacked Biden. He said, "Biden said the new sanctions would affect the Russian space program. Okay, maybe President Biden is off topic, so explain to him that the correlation of the station's orbit, its avoidance of dangerous rendezvous with space debris, is avoided by the thrust of the engines of the Russian Progress MS cargo ships." In our next update, we'll see the FAA delaying SpaceX's Starbase environmental review to the end of March. As per recent reports, the Federal Aviation Administration has revealed that the Programmatic Environmental Assessment (PEA) for SpaceX's Starbase will be completed no earlier than the 28th of March, 2022. In the first delay, the FAA had pushed back the PEA completion date from the 31st of December, 2021 to the 28th of February, 2022. Now they shifted the expected date to late March, thus adding another 4 weeks of waiting to get the PEA. In their official Twitter page, the regulatory agency wrote, "The FAA continues its programmatic environmental assessment for the proposed SpaceX Starship Super Heavy project in Boca Chica, Texas. The new target date for issuing the final PEA is March 28th. In the past few years, these sort of delays for SpaceX Starbase launch operations have made the FAA earn a certain ill repute, and this recent addition of delays worsens its fame further. Sources state that this recent delay is caused more by other U.S. government agencies rather than the FAA. Through a Freedom of Information Act request, it comes out that two major U.S. government agencies are responsible for the delay. One is the U.S.'s Department of Fish and Wildlife Services, also known as FWS, and second one is the National Parks Services, or NPS. By late October 2021, the NPS had a list of about 31 comments on SpaceX's Starbase draft PEA which we're mostly criticizing. These comments have covered almost all aspects, varying from Starbase development to Starship orbital launches, lighting system of the launch pads, the quality of air in launch facility, noise levels, technical aspects regarding Raptor engine thrust, or the painting type of process. It also points on SpaceX's land acquisitions, as well as their road closures for testing or launches. It even questions about SpaceX's contingency plans, as well as impacts on a Civil War battlefield landmark which is near the Texas facility. And sources state that all of those comments need to have a detailed response with further modifications as per situation develops. This will take a long period of time, and thus the delay seems inevitable. Another station, the Department of the Interior, or DOI, has raised an alarming voice on launch site blast area hazards, closure of FWS and NPS lands, environmental justice concerns. They all pointed out concerns on endangered species, air quality emissions, and climate change impacts from Starbase and Starship. According to SpaceX's draft PEA, they'll develop a natural gas power plant to serve their requirements. The trio of DOI, FWS, and NPS criticized that emissions from this future power plant may violate the rules of the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency. Following this draft, reports have come up that SpaceX may go for developing a new power distribution line which will connect Boca Chica and Brownsville and eliminate the need for developing any dedicated power plants on site except a power source to work as backup. But still, now, SpaceX hasn't conveyed any such change of plans to either FAA or other stakeholders of Starbase PEA. If the approvals of DOI, FWS, and NPS come in a well-shaped manner, then Starbase PEA will reach its final form. But if obtaining proved to be a failure, then SpaceX may have to start from the beginning again for another environmental impact statement. This will cause a massive delay, which is not wanted in such a large-scale, ambitious project. There are chances that SpaceX will shift their focus from Texas Starbase to Florida launch site and proceed there for Starship orbital launches. SpaceX already has full environmental approval to carry out 24 Starship launches over a year from its Kennedy Space Center Pad 39A facilities. But Starbase will remain, as in the recent Starship update. Musk implied that SpaceX would never abandon Starbase and might use the site as a sort of dedicated research and development facility. We'll wrap up with the update regarding U.S. and other major nations planning to share the cost for launching the new wideband global SATCOM 11 Plus satellite to space. In recent times, officials from the United States and WSG partner nations are having discussions for paving the way of attaining a cost-sharing agreement to fund the WGS 11 Plus satellite launch. Keith Anderson, business and financial manager for Military SATCOM International Partners, stated, "The Department of the Air Force and the U.S. Space Force conducted exploratory discussions with current WGS partners and two new partners to meet the costs associated with launch and ground integration of WGS 11 Plus throughout its acquisition strategy development. Earlier, WGS 11 Plus was not planned to be bought by the Pentagon. The Air Force's budget was funding for WGS satellites only up to the 10 already ordered from Boeing. And to include WGS 11 Plus and beyond, Congress had added $600 million to the Air Force's budget. The Air Force said the funding was only enough for one satellite, but it would have significantly more capacity, thus a $605 million contract was awarded to Boeing for developing WGS 11 Plus. At present, Keith Anderson's office is under the U.S. Space Systems Command in Los Angeles. As per reports, this Space Systems Command is buying the WGS 11 Plus satellite. It's planned to be launched in 2024. These WGS satellites provide broadband communications to the U.S. military and allies. WGS partner nations include Canada, the Czech Republic, Denmark, Luxembourg, Netherlands, New Zealand, and Norway. Anderson said, "At this time, all currently signed partners have committed to providing additional funding to the WGS program, subject to the successful conclusion of an international agreement." Anderson also said that the $600 million appropriated by Congress allowed Space Systems Command to procure a robust satellite vehicle, roughly doubling the capacity of the earlier WGS-10. There was enthusiastic interest from international partners to collaborate on WGS 11+, allowing partners to provide additional funding for the program, including some launch costs. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.